We are here in Levi's Stadium in front of at least 70,000 people. It is packed. And right now, it's the culmination. It's the boiling point of all of DCA's biggest feuds and rivalries. And they are all set to take place here in Revelations.
It's going to be one hell of a night, guys.
V-Pac alongside Eddie Mack, Zahia Steele. We'll be joined later by Timmy Dangerously, the voices of Faces vs. Heels. And what a night we have in store for you, ladies and gentlemen.
Without a doubt. I mean, you look at the card, you look at some of the matches. It's all big money matches here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. It's all a big deal, and we are going to get things right off the start hot. It's gonna get crazy.
Casey Gordon versus Zack Stone for the DCA World Heavyweight Championship. A last woman standing match for the Wildcats title. We got a four-way for the Wildcats tag team title. And speaking of Wildcats, control the Wildcats will be decided here tonight as well. A lot of the future of the Destiny Championship Alliance will be shaped from these events here tonight.
Not to mention they got DCA's version of King Kong versus Godzilla when Candice Romero and Morgan Raincross face off one-on-one with each other.
I am looking forward to that one. Plus, we got a Santa Clara street fight. They'll start in the parking lot of this very building, and they'll eventually end up in the ring. Dani Gibbons and Cleopatra Sphinx tonight. We have a four-way for the Wildcats Fever Championship. We have a 2 out of 3 falls match for the DCA Celestial Championship. I feel like I'm missing something. This is ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a big night.
A lot of matches, a lot of stakes on the line. It's bound to be one hell of a night, ladies and gentlemen.
And it looks like we're going to be starting things off with the tag team title match.
We do have a bit of breaking news if you have not been following on the DCA Facebook fan page. Oh, by the way, if you want to talk about it on social media, use the hashtag RevelationsTFA. And here's that breaking news I was talking about. Yes, those are the challenges. Those are the scheduled challenges for this tag team title match. BillyLee.
Billy Edmonds, Lee Ramirez got to this point by beating the members of Too Wicked when it seemed like the ball was not in their court. They were able to find a way to persevere, to move on. And now they are at Revelations fighting for the tag team titles.
And here is that breaking news I'm about to tell you about. You know that team that BillyLee beat?
Yes. Oh, what? What?
They're holding the tag team titles right now. At a DCA live event in Jacksonville, Florida, a few weeks ago, Too Wicked defeated the Real Wrestling Throwbacks for the tag team titles.
Well, I guess that just pretty much proves that anything can happen in the world of professional wrestling.
Sure as hell wasn't expecting this.
See, this is what happens when you don't follow DCA on the Facebook, man. You would have known this. You would have known this.
I guess that's my fault, but nonetheless, it looks like BillyLee are going to have to go up against Too Wicked one more time in order to get those DCA tag team titles.
I'm sure BillyLee is aware of it. I'm sure BillyLee have been aware of it for about good 3 weeks or so now.
So here we go. Tag team titles on the line.
Alright, so being the new guy here, who is actually who?
That is Johnny Sinclair for 2 weeks, starting off with Billy Edmonds.
Is now Billy Edmonds. Oh, God! Oh, with the right hand Sinclair. From Johnny Sinclair.
Sinclair is having none of whatever Billy Edmonds is selling.
And you know, 2 Wicked have to be steaming because they were beaten in singles matches by both members of BillyLee. Right. So a little bit of retribution here tonight for the team of 2 Wicked.
And ironically, oh, hang on. Cover by Emma's and a quick one count. My 2 Wicked, as recently as about 3 weeks ago, weren't even on the card for... weren't even on the main card for Revelations.
Cover.
Oh, didn't even get a one count off of that pin there. Is now sends Billy Edmonds into the corner. Oh, catches a boot, sends him right back, does Billy Edmonds.
Billy telling Johnny, come get you some now.
As now sends him into the corner. Tag out to Lee Ramirez here. Is now Snapmare. Shinlock. And a huge boot to the head.
Take that.
Into the pin. Hooks the leg. Cover. Two. And no.
Nice jawbreaker there by Lee
Ramirez.
Ramirez. Okay.
Is now Lee Ramirez going to work here. Is now going on to the pin after that leg drop, only getting a two count.
Brother.
You know, this is a very nice clothesline there. Tag out. Gets caught with that hip toss. You know, like I was going to say, this is a big night for BillyLee. They fought hard to get this shot. They have it. Now it's just their time to capitalize.
Oh, look out.
Give it to them.
Oh, that again.
Launch it to the outside.
And the challenges for the tag titles are in the driver's seat.
Yeah, things are not looking good for 2 Wicked at the moment.
Now Lee Ramirez is still going to work here. What is this? Oh, nice jawbreaker there.
Mike Sullivan getting worked over here in the early going here. He hasn't gotten a lick of minimal. I should say minimal. Oh, goodness. And probably not the time to... be proud of your handiwork there. And now, Forceful stabbing it in the face by Ramirez.
Just a straight up knee there.
By the way, BillyLee, it was at this event last season that BillyLee first teamed up, you know, before they were, you know, BillyLee, capital letters, if you will. They first teamed up at the last Revelations, and it was the first time Billy Edmonds won a match at DCA. They have become a formidable tag team. They've become a formidable tag team since then. They want to celebrate their anniversary, so to speak, by winning the tag team titles. But right now, it's not looking too good for him as Sinclair with a back suplex.
Nice back suplex. And what a way to culminate entire journey as a tag team by winning those tag team titles, just to show the progress that you've made as a tag team by winning the most prestigious prize in DCA.
Nice missile dropkick there by Lee Ramirez.
Cover or near fall. Now all four men, was involuntarily, and then T-bone suplex by Sinclair.
Johnny Sinclair not wasting any time to taunt his opponent.
But he's wasting time and following up.
Now tag out to Mike Sullivan here. Now what is this? Now has him. Oh, and a nice double backbreaker.
That was brutal.
Yeah, Lee's definitely going to be feeling that one.
As now what is this? Mike Sullivan now. Oh my god!
On his face.
Now here's the cover.
Into the pin, hooks the leg. Oh, but broken up there by Billy Edmonds. As now Lee Ramirez looks to gain some ground here. Irish whip. No, wait a second. Oh, wait. Victory roll.
Nice counter.
Reverse by Ramirez. Wait. Two. No, and now three first. Three first by Solomon. Shows it down in here for.
Back and forth action here as Mike Sullivan hits him with that huge forearm into the corner. And now just raining down the punches to the side of the head of Lee Ramirez. And right now, BillyLee seemed to be in trouble here. Is now tagging out to Johnny Sinclair.
Sinclair does.
And now what is this? And again! Ooh. Again! They just dropped Lee Ramirez right down on his face.
Now you can tell Lee's definitely feeling the effects of that one.
Wait a minute! What? Stolz it down too! Ooh!
Wait a second, gets caught! Exploder suplex from Johnny Sinclair!
Also here tonight, a revelation for the first time, Dani Gibbons will take on Cleopatra Sphinx.
Yeah, that should be a hell of a match. And
oh, elbow drop by Sinclair is no good. And
but Johnny Sinclair quick to stay on the attack, but so does Lee Ramirez. Now look at this float over DDT. Nice recovery by Lee Ramirez. And here comes Billy Edmonds.
Right hand sends Sinclair down. Elbow shot sends Sullivan down. Another close on sends Sinclair down again. And another.
He's coming in like a house of fire here.
Billy Edmonds coming at him with the strikes and a huge strike to take him down.
Billy Edmonds with the elbow. This has been a hell of a match so far.
Billy Edmonds on fire here, trying to get something going for his team now. Here he comes into the corner. No, misses. Johnny Sinclair moves out of the way. Kick to the midsection. Wait a second. Oh, trying to go for another punch. But right now, it's just these two men just going at it right now.
Sinclair gained the advantage. He's staggered Edmonds, but Edmonds able to recover. Electric chair drop.
Let's not also forget, guys, we still have Atlas Jones and Smokey later tonight. They're going to face off in a very heated grudge match.
Red D will be taking on Zach Starr as well tonight. Oh, my goodness, what a right hand by Emmett.
Now Johnny Sinclair, no, gets caught with that atomic drop there and gets spiked to the mat with that DDT. And I believe Johnny Sinclair has been busted open.
Or as somebody in CCL likes to say,
We got a bleeder! Oh, look out! Declan! German suplex to Ramirez!
I always wanted to say that.
As now Johnny Sinclair... Oh, wait a second! Gets caught with that atomic drop and a double axe handle. And now what is this? Billy Edmonds now. Oh, getting a little crazy here with that elbow drop!
Unleashing his inner Dusty Rhodes.
Into the pin. Two, no!
Drop kick sends Sinclair down, and now Lee going after Mike Sullivan, but Sinclair, the legal man. Oh, wait a minute!
Wait a second!
What?
A pump handle tombstone!
Jesus!
I don't think I've ever seen anything like that.
I don't.
My thoughts exactly.
He calls out the Jersey Turnpike and Too Wicked Man retain the tag title.
An unbelievable kick out from Billy Edmonds there.
How did Edmonds kick out of that is beyond me.
No, Edmonds coming back. Just firing some strikes into the head. Already to the bloody head of Johnny Sinclair. Now going up top. Uh-oh.
It's going up. Looking for the frog splash. And he did not get it.
Put the knees up at the last second.
Johnny Sinclair was smart enough to get the knees right at the very last minute, and now Billy Edmonds in trouble as Mike Sullivan takes him down with the Bulldog.
All four men in the ring, and the referee got a little bit of control. I think it's, I guess it solved itself.
And now you can see the picture here. Billy Edmonds all alone with Too Wicked. It's now Mike Sullivan with the sunset flip powerbomb, and it is not looking good for Billy Edmonds here. And now Too Wicked again, double backbreaker. Lee Ramirez tries to get something going for his team here. Wait a second, oh no, not again.
Jersey Turnpike. Look, Edmonds is the legal man and Edmonds is up.
Johnny Sinclair better turn around. Wait a second. Oh, it's pretty an atomic drop.
Evans down with the drop kick.
Evans got to come up with something big, and he's got to come up with something big right now. Either that or tag in Lee.
I mean, would that even be a good idea?
That's a good
just
point.
Just took a Jersey Turnpike just a little while ago, and now Billy Edmonds just got taken down with an exploder suplex, and now Mike Sullivan getting tagged into this one. Wait a second, misses the punch.
He forgot to press X.
I understood that reference. But Sullivan able to recover. Edmonds staggered. Now what's Sullivan got here? What's he got in mind? Oh my
god. Oh!
Gory neck breaker!
Here's a cover.
Two, three. Oh! No!
Wait. Oh wait.
Billy Edmonds! Oh my god! And now going up top!
Oh my god! It's coming in!
No! Oh, a charbroiled splash!
This is it!
There's the cover!
One, two, three! Yes!
Did it!
The only way is that!
At Revelation, these two formed a tag team, and now in their anniversary match, they become DCA Tag Team Champions.
It's been a long time coming for Billy Edmonds and Lee Ramirez.
A long road.
They deserve it.
A long road, a long journey, but in the end, they found what they were looking for. Billy Lee, your new DCA Tag Team Champions.
There was the gory neckbreaker by Sullivan, but it only got a two.
Right here, this would be the end. This would turn the match around. Billy Lee's favor. After that pile driver, and then Billy Edmonds would submit Billy Lee's legacy here in DCA with that charbroil splash.
And Sinclair in no condition to make the save as he just got wrinkle flexed out there on the floor. Congratulations to Billy Edmonds and Lee Ramirez, your new DCA Tag Team Champions.
What a way to kick off Revelations.
I don't know how the hell we're going to
We've got like 15 other matches. I'm sure we'll get to that point.
Yep. Exactly.
And we have a limo arriving.
And look who it is!
It is Lucinda Red Eye, I fear. She will be taking on Envy later tonight. And the winner of that match will get control of DCA Wildcats. She's standing by with Brittany. I cannot wait for that match.
Yeah, I hope Lucinda rips Envy apart.
Well, whatever the outcome may be, we are pretty much guaranteed one hell of a fight.
By the way, that match is for the control of DCA Wildcats. You could probably imagine, you know, you could probably assume that the loser of this match is probably gone from this company. I would have to think.
Well, hey, I gotta agree with Eddie on that one.
I mean, it's probably in the case of Envy loses, because you know she's still got, you know, the Dynasty and the DCA Wildcats champion. But I can almost assure you, it's a definite if Lucinda loses.
The old saying goes, there's only, this town is not big enough for two of those women. And only one of them is going to be in charge of the Wildcats division come the end of the night.
And if you think about it, gentlemen, if Lucinda is gone, then the last trace of DCA founder D-Wall, gone. And who knows where this company goes from here.
Yeah, I'd like not to think about that right now.
I know it's a frightening thought, and we've had to deal with many, many, many frightening thoughts in recent months. You know what I'm talking about. I will not go into it, but yeah.
Well, that all is going to come late. One of those two women will control the Wildcats division. Will it be Envy? Will it be Lucinda? We don't know, but for right now, we got another match.
Here comes the Glock.
These women scare me.
Yeah, they scare me too. This is my first time seeing them, and I'm already intimidated by them.
This match was made a few weeks ago after repeated attacks on both Hana and Suzumi, and it was Hana Brightly that asked for this match. I'm not really sure why. But apparently, Hana and Suzumi, as far as we know, the two are friends. At least that's how Hana tells it. And here is Hana Brightly, who I believe, if I'm not mistaken, wasn't good with it. It was Emergence, I believe, that Hana made her DCA debut.
This woman always makes me happy.
I know, she's got a sunny disposition. I still don't get why she would want to, I mean, other than, you know, other than having common enemies in the Glocks, I don't know why you would want to team. I'm sorry, it was Wildcats DXD, I'm sorry. That's the, yeah. Hana tried to befriend Suzumi, and I don't know if they're friends, Hana believes they are, but they have a common... They have a common enemy, if you will, and... Hello. This is, That's some...
Similar to her sister's attire.
Right!
Is that saying something, or is, are we just gonna ignore that? Should we be scared right now, is what I'm basically asking.
Should we be scared? The answer is yes. Gentlemen, I'm gonna level with you. I don't know how the hell Suzumi and Hana are gonna coexist as a team.
Well, we've seen some strange pairings here in DCA.
I mean, Suzumi's...
In all the, and,
I mean...
What?
Her sister? Suzumi's sister is the Wildcats champion, Akira Yukimura. The leader of the Dynasty.
But she is. And Hana, she's the...
It's
I mean, take nothing away from Hana Brightly. She is a very well-known... Very, very good wrestler in that ring. She has been in that ring with some of the toughest women in the world.
Ooh.
With that being said, she and Suzumi have very different personalities. And like you said, Eddie Mac, I have no idea how these two are going to coexist with each other.
You think it's possible that Suzumi dressed up like her sister to try to spread intimidation into the Glocks?
Oh, you notice Suzumi moved there? When Hana won, you noticed that, right?
Yeah.
Hana won the tag Suzumi in and Suzumi move. We all saw that. I want to make sure we all saw that.
Already showing cracks in this new form tag team. And they're going to have to get over whatever it is that they're going through if they want to get their hands on the Glocks. Right now...
That was a Dota Q match, by the way.
Oh, fantastic. And we're going to get our first look at Terra. This is Roxy, I'm sorry. Oh!
Roxy now.
No, correction. This is Terra. This is Terra. I always get the two mixed up.
Terra now just hammering away at the back of Hana, and Hannah's just... Wait a second, Hana now fighting back here. I go for a chop. It gets caught.
I think she might have seen two or three Terras there. Terra's had an issue with Hana for months. I'm sure it's philosophical more than anything else. I mean,
ooh! Knife edge chop across the chest.
I mean, it really makes sense when you think about it, because you know the Glocks, you know. They represent everything, you know,
that Hana is
mean,
right.
And Hana is, like, pretty much in every single way the opposite of the Glocks.
I should point this out again, ladies and gentlemen. This is a no disqualification match. And now, what a power bomb by Roxy! Cover!
That power bomb only gets a two count, but my God, did you... See the height she got off of that powerbomb.
Lord.
And I was wondering if Suzumi was going to try to break that pin up.
I think she was, but I'm not 100% sure.
She was definitely hesitant about breaking up that pin.
Terra back in. There's a side Russian leg sweep. I mean, the Glocks, they're not technically sound by any stretch of the imagination, but they can damn sure fight.
Not fighting.
They don't look like they love to fight.
Oh, dropping Hana around in their face. So far, the Glocks have been doing a good job just keeping, you know, Hana cornered, making sure she can't get anywhere near Suzumi. But even though if she could, I'm not sure Suzumi would want Hana anywhere near her. Now, get
out
in security.
Yes, Hana needs a tag. I don't know if Suzumi's going to give it to her, but Hana needs a tag.
You know, Hana, she's scrappy. She's got a lot of heart, but I don't even think she can overcome a two-on-one assault.
Knees right into the back of Hana by, that's Roxy, right?
That is Roxy, yes. And there's a back suplex.
Into the pin, off of that back suplex, into the cover. And Suzumi able to break it up this time.
I mean, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Does anyone actually expect Hana and Suzumi to win this match?
I mean, anyone has a fighting chance.
James Ellsworth said, any man or woman with two hands has a fighting chance.
Oh, God. You know, it's not looking good for you when we have to quote James Ellsworth.
I like James Ellsworth. I mean, you have to think Suzumi.
I mean,
speaking of Suzumi.
Oh, wait a second. A comet drop from Hana. Oh, he gets taken down with the drop toe hold.
Suzumi, on a few episodes ago in Wildcats, was busted open there. Was busted open at the hands of the Glocks, and I guess she broke up that pin not so much to help Hana, but to make sure the Glocks do not win.
Oh, but look at Hana right now. Hana's now fighting back. And here
Hana's
she comes.
To fire herself off.
My God.
I think she would learn from the first time she tried that.
Oh, palm strike. And now she tagged it to Suzumi.
Suzumi's in.
Oh, wait a second.
This time she forgot to press A.
And now Suzumi just going up against the Glocks right now.
Super kick!
One, two.
No!
The Young Bucks would have been proud of those super kicks.
Backbreaker, neckbreaker combination there. And now gets caught by Suzumi.
I wonder if Terra was looking for the Colt 45. She was getting a full head of steam there.
Now Suzumi, wait a second. Oh, gets caught with the neckbreaker. Again, the Glocks just working as a well-oiled tag team.
But Suzumi dumping Roxy to the outside.
And now it takes down Terra. And now it is a blind shot!
I thought she was aiming for...
She might have been, but she... the good news of falling short is she landed on Terra, but it is Roxy that is the legal woman in this match right now.
Yeah, Roxy just
took advantage there, and she sent her into the steel steps.
And a
rolling savate kick from Suzumi.
And Roxy fights back the knee to the face, but
Suzumi right back with a flapjack, and Suzumi, she may have to win this thing on her own for her team, and Suzumi,
ow, that backfired big time.
That's why it's called high risk, ladies and gentlemen. Flapjack! Cutter go away! She got right back to her feet!
Holy shit! But Iizuka ends that. I mean, she may be the prodigy of the dynasty, but...
I mean, in the most case of this match, it's been two versus one. Suzumi and Hana, they have not been able to work well together as a team so far, and the Glocks have been taking full advantage of that.
Right.
Exactly.
Wait a second, Suzumi now. Rolling Snapmare into a kick to the chest! Into the pin.
Hooked over by Suzumi.
Gets broken up by Roxy there. There's now. Oh, wait a second. Look at this!
Oh, look at this!
A little bit of teamwork from Suzumi and Hannah Brightly!
And listen to this crowd!
The first instance of teamwork between Suzumi and Hannah. This crowd loves it!
Kick camera!
Yep, counter by Tara.
And a nice gut buster there. And now Tara taking out Hannah. They're just going after Hannah. Hannah not having any of it, though. Now Suzumi kick to the midsection, and now just dragging Tara back into the ring.
Tara, oh my god!
What a spear!
That might just...
Tara's setting something up here.
Oh, there's the Colt 45.
And it may be over. Wait a second, Hannah! Knee to the back! And now Roxy! Getting Hannah out of here! It's now...
Oh,
and it's a dirty... And Suzumi... Wait, no, Suzumi! Knee to the midsection!
Look at him! Tiger Bomb! Hannah going to work on Roxy on the outside!
And this leaves Suzumi with some chance here. Wait a second. No, Tara! Kick to the midsection! And now... Wait a second!
Oh! Oh,
what a kick by Suzumi!
Hit the right
kick
to the head!
Oh, but gets broken up again by Roxy!
Oh!
I gotta say, Suzumi and Hana are—they're definitely putting up more of a fight than I think anybody thought they would.
You're not kidding. I was joking. More kicks, and now Hana. Maybe with an opportunity to put this thing away here, as Suzumi and Roxy are flying on the outside. And what is?
Oh no!
What is Hana doing?
No way!
What is Hana doing?
Stop you! Oh,
oh my! Oh my god! Oh! Ow! Oh. Oh.
Tara ruining a perfectly good worm there.
Oh my!
And she's got a chair.
The no DQ rule coming into effect right now.
This is not good for Hana.
This is not looking good for Hana. Wait a second! Roll up!
And the scoreboard! No!
No!
I thought this was no disqualification. How come there's rope breaks?
No, that's,
There are some questions that are left better unanswered. And now... Alabama slam!
Oh boy.
Oh, now there we go.
Lined up here.
This isn't looking good for Hannah.
Here she comes, Hannah!
Oh! Right in the chair!
Roll up!
Roll up! Score!
She got her! Holy crap!
What an upset!
Hannah Brightly! Suzumi!
What?!
They just beat the Glocks!
Hannah Brightly won a match at Revelations! Let's let that sink in for a minute!
Let's let this sink in right here. Right when we thought Tara had her, Hannah Brightly... They encounters by sending her head into the steel chair, and then with the roll-up in which it was able to get her, the quick three count. A true underdog victory here for Hana Brightly.
This has to be one of the biggest upsets in DCA history.
Well, there you can see Morgan Raincroft and Candice Romero getting ready backstage. They're going to face off later on tonight.
Yeah, I hope the ring's reinforced for that one.
Two of the most dominant women in virtual wrestling. They have never met in a one-on-one match, or for that matter, any match until tonight. And I got goosebumps for this one.
Not just us, but you have to believe that Morgan Raincroft has goosebumps going. I mean, especially after everything that has been said by Candice, not just by Candice, but by almost everyone in the DCA community, that there's a possible chance that she maybe can't get the job done against Candice Romero tonight.
So how you mentioned it, this is more than just a match for Morgan. This is an opportunity for her to prove herself that, you know, she still has it. She's still got it. She still has what it takes to be the most dominant woman in virtual wrestling, because if you saw in the last Wildcats, Candice Romero straight up questioned that if the Morgan basically told her, if this Morgan is the Morgan I face at Revelations, I'm going to tear you apart, kid.
Well, let's not forget, Morgan Raincroft held the women's title for how long?
400 days plus.
And she definitely doesn't want to be in second place either.
Right. She's not used to being second to anybody, but second is what she's been quite often as of late. You know, that free fall her own cell match against Power. Even though she won that match, it took everything she had. This isn't the same. I got a feeling the Morgan we see tonight may not be the same Morgan that Candice saw in the last broadcast. I got a feeling that the Morgan Raincroft that Candice Romero sees tonight will be the Morgan Raincroft of old. And I hope it is. Because if it is, I think we're in for a match that will be talked about for a long time to come.
Well, we will only see once that match takes place. We will see whether Candice is facing the new Morgan Raincroft or the Morgan Raincroft of old.
Wonder if your home guy, you know, guy in your head by now. Hana Brightly just won a match at DC.
I always root for the underdog, but nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, we have the Celestial Championship on the line next. 2 out of 3 falls. TJ Kennedy taking on Tyler Parks. We're going to find out who really is the best pure wrestler here in DCA.
Gonna be a hell of a match. Fans definitely waiting in anticipation for this one.
As they should be, we are about to witness a technical classic. Here you can see the young lion, the DCA Celestial Champion, TJ Kennedy, making his way down to the ring.
At Gateway to Heaven, Kennedy won the vacated Celestial Championship. It was a Gateway to Heaven, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
He won that championship from Tyler Parks, and Tyler wants to bring that championship back to the blacklist.
But he doesn't want to do it with just one victory. He wants to prove without a shadow of a doubt that he is better than TJ Kennedy. That is why he has made this match. 2 out of 3 falls.
He calls himself wrestling elite. Tonight he's gonna have to prove it.
And you know, Tyler Parks, you know, maybe the last time these two went up against each other, Tyler Parks underestimated TJ Kennedy. He underestimated the young lion, and because of that, TJ Kennedy was able to pull up the upset win against Tyler Parks at Gateway to Heaven. But now, you have to believe Tyler Parks, he is ready, he's focused, he knows what TJ Kennedy is capable of, and he is looking to get that Celestial title back.
And if you notice, there's no other members of the Blacklist, let alone Shazeen at ringside here.
I noticed that. I wonder why. I mean, I want to believe Tyler's intentions, but he is Blacklist, so yeah.
You can never trust the Blacklist at any point in time. We've known this. He's gotta have eyes in the back of his head.
I'm sorry. Run that. Some people may have missed that. The point you just made.
TJ Kennedy about how he can't see the Blacklist, but the Blacklist is always around.
Yes, that one.
And how he's going to have eyes in the back of his head.
Uh-huh. I mean, you know the Blacklist is... I know it's only Tyler out there, but the Blacklist is looking around somewhere. But, on the other hand, maybe Tyler really does want to do it on his own. Maybe he wants to bring the title back to the Blacklist on his own. He doesn't want an asterisk, you know, by, he wanted the title back, ... with help. He doesn't want the ... and all that after that. That's his ego talking. Maybe he really does want to do it on his own.
And he does bring up a good point there.
You know, maybe that is the case. Maybe he does want to do this on his own without an asterisk. But again, like I said, it's the Blacklist, and you can never trust the Blacklist.
I agree with you 100%, but Tyler, and I'm not taking this side by any stretch of the imagination. I like his athleticism, but I don't like his character. But let's think about this for a second. He cannot call himself wrestling elite if he wins the title back tonight with help. For his own conscience, he has to do. I don't know if he wants to do it on his own, but for his conscience, he has to do it on his own.
Maybe that's the case. And he's going to have a lot to prove here tonight. He's going up against a man who I've seen grow here in DCA after winning that Celestial Championship. I mean, we're talking about TJ Kennedy, the same TJ Kennedy who went 30 minutes with the DCA World Champion, who went toe-to-toe with Casey Gordon for 30 freaking minutes.
And speaking of that, we still have a huge world title match tonight with Casey Gordon and Zack Stone.
Pair of DCA Day Oneers will be... Oh, hang on, cover. Off the floor of a suplex in just a one. It's been quite some time that two DCA Day Oneers will face off for the biggest prize in the company.
Right now you can see TJ Kennedy and Tyler Parks, right now they're just going back and forth with each other, exchanging holds, trying to go for quick pinfalls, but nothing seems to be working. They're trying to get a feel for each other, which is very smart in this 2 out of 3 falls match.
Max suplex
Day Oneers?
Yeah, Day Oneers.
That's a first.
No, wait a second, Jawbreaker. And TJ Kennedy into the pin, hooks the leg, only getting a one count. You can see they're still trying to go for quick pins. And, you know, in my mind, I'm not sure that's a good idea. You mean you go for more pins, you start wearing yourself out. You start going for more holds. You keep going at your opponent, and you continue the stalemate. You're going to get worn out eventually. And I think that's what these two are trying to do, but it may...
Oh, Lord! Ooh. What is
it? It may not work out for anyone. But Tyler Parks just caught TJ Kennedy square with that enziguri.
Vinny, to follow up on the Day Oneers thing. Casey and Zach, they were in DCA. Oh my God, what a German! They were in DCA. They came into DCA together about 3.5 years ago. You know, when DCA started. Day Oneers.
Oh, that makes sense. Okay.
Tyler Parks also a Day Oneer.
You notice, even though these guys are hitting some big moves, some big suplexes, they're still only getting one counts on their opponent. Which makes you think, how much longer can these two go with just going back and forth with each other?
They have been going at a frantic pace since the opening, opening bell. And, you know, every pinfall attempt, that's less energy for the guy that kicks out. That may be the purpose of these quick pins here.
Now you can see Tyler Parks now going for a strategy here, now looking to work on the legs of TJ Kennedy.
Worked on one leg, but the other leg's still working fine.
Now TJ Kennedy, what's he thinking of here? Has him set up on the middle. Oh, and a nice cross body.
And now Kennedy's going upstairs.
Oh, no water in the pool on that senton splash. And Tyler, I'm surprised not. Oh! Never mind.
It's now, oh, wait a second. What is this? Oh, an inverted sharpshooter, I believe, by Tyler Parks in the middle of the ring on TJ Kennedy. But we already see a submission victory here.
Kennedy might be in trouble here.
He's nowhere near the ropes either.
He can't move. Tyler Parks is not letting him move. He's got both legs hooked, which is making it nearly impossible for TJ Kennedy to gain any leverage.
Also got that knee, driving that knee into the lower back right there.
Oh, wait a second. TJ Kennedy now trying to look for that bottom rope. And he does, thankfully, but I don't know. Those legs, he was in that hold for a long time, and those legs cannot feel good.
His back can't be feel much better, for that matter.
Wait a second, yep. Sunset flip!
Covered by Tyler! Nope!
Can't it? First. And a near fall.
DJ Kennedy now, what's he thinking of here? Oh wait, gets caught, small package!
Throws it down, two! No! Only two.
Oh, and TJ Kennedy catches Tyler Parks with that enziguri. His legs can't be in that much trouble if he's able to do a picture-perfect enziguri like that one.
Oh, that's a good point.
Now look at this. Oh! Oh!
Woohoo!
What a counter by Kennedy!
Into the pin off of that Explorer Suplex!
Oh!
It's a two count, though!
How close was that, though?
TJ Kennedy now. Oh, look at this! Schoolboy! No, too close to the ropes there.
Tyler's a big dude. He's like 6'6".
Oh, and a nice dropkick! You talk about a man who's 6'6 and can do a dropkick like that!
Yeah, Okada would be proud of that.
Look at this!
Yeah, replay that.
Just not only the strength, but the quickness of that Exploder Suplex. After catching him in midair, once Tyler Parks tried to go for that clothesline.
Yep.
Al Kennedy, what's he got in mind here? Oh! Oh, no!
Oh, my God!
Oh, Lord. That's... Well, that's going to be bad times for TJ. It's going to be bad times right there.
TJ Kennedy could be out.
Load a suplex.
Two, and he got... Oh, he did not get him! Only two!
Wait a second.
Wait, now what's Tyler doing?
Oh, I think Tyler was looking on the gold rush with TJ counters! Now the man has scored a fall in this match. It is best of three.
Second. Schoolboy!
He's got
Tyler Parks!
Two! No.
Kennedy down sent to the corner.
Oh, big stinger splash!
And now TJ Kennedy sends Tyler Parks into the corner here. Missed with the drop kick. Oh, wait a second!
Gold rush!
Tyler Parks!
Gold rush!
Oh!
Tyler scores with the gold rush!
And Tyler Parks picks up the first fall!
One more fall and Tyler Parks wins the Celestial title!
Now... TJ Kennedy...
Hey, come on, this is a no-DQ! God,
wait here! Oh no!
Come on now! No! Jesus!
And now Tyler Parks looking for the countout victory. And so I thought, never mind going, now bringing him back in. He has to go quickly for the cover. This has to be it. Two. No!
Three.
Whoa, wait! Oh!
Out of nowhere, TJ Kennedy gets the second fall!
How in the hell was TJ Kennedy? Look at this! The gold rush into the steel!
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And in all seriousness, this match should have been over after that.
I don't know how the hell Parks didn't get disqualified for that.
And then here, I thought the match was over here in the pin off that gold rush, but I somehow TJ Kennedy able to get the shoulder off, and it was quick enough to get the quick schoolboy pin.
And suddenly we are deadlocked at a fall apiece. And now Kennedy, that's who was gonna go for there, but we'll never know now.
You gotta wonder though what kind of condition TJ Kennedy is in is after taking that gold rush on the steel steps though.
Cannot be feeling good, but he's gotta block out the pain. Both men 1-1 next. Oh, wins the fight! Championship!
Nice power slam counter by Tyler.
Kennedy back up to swing and a miss on the instant guard, but Tyler did not miss on his.
And now Tyler Parks looking to put this one away. Up on his shoulder. Wait a second. No, reverse DDT by TJ Kennedy.
Oh my goodness.
TJ's got to avoid that gold rush at all costs.
Kick to the midsection there. Wait a second. Roll up.
Schoolboy! Near fall.
Jackknife pin here. Two. No. And now again.
Wait,
no,
wait.
No. Reverse.
Again. Dropping the elbow is TJ Kennedy.
Oh, wait. Wait a second. He has him.
Here we go.
Gold rush.
Gold rush.
But he's not going for the pin.
That's a mistake right there. Taunting to the crowd.
And TJ Kennedy. Wait a second. Wait.
Oh, my goodness.
Seven degrees of trauma and another one.
14 degrees of trauma.
It looks like a third one.
Oh, it's going to be called that. It's
out of trauma.
And Tyler's up.
He's back up.
Tyler's up.
How is Tyler up after taking three of those?
Three of them.
He just took 21 degrees of trauma there, but now. Oh, no. Here he goes again.
Gold rush.
Gold rush!
This has to be it. No! Bad ring positioning there from Tyler Parks.
Yeah, TJ got lucky on that one.
Kick to the midsection. Another kick there.
Both men have to be in some serious pain right now.
Wait a second, German suplex! Could this be it? Could he do it? Can he hit it? The Kennedy effect!
This is it!
Oh, running dropkick to the face!
And now, wait a second! Oh no! Right to the eye! And now, that's planting him with the DDT!
Oh my goodness!
Got a knee drop, and I think, he just opened up TJ Kennedy. But TJ Kennedy is still trying to fight back, and another into Gary.
Jesus. What is it going to take?
And now you can see Tyler Parks is trying to open up Kennedy some more. Now look at this, Tyler Parks. Off the rope, trying to go for a moonsault.
Oh, very un-Tyler Parks like there.
Keyword being tried, wasn't successful.
Nope.
Reverse DDT.
I don't know what it's going to take at this point for one of these two to win this thing.
You might actually have to kill one of these men to keep them down, as now. Try to go for another enziguri.
Or throw a tank on one of them.
Oh, wait. Reverse DDT after he tried to go for another gold rush. Right to the eye. Nagare missed. Wait a second.
Wait.
7 degrees of trauma.
7 degrees of trauma.
This could be it. Two.
Kennedy
got him.
Kennedy retains in one hell of a match.
Eastman just went out there and traded big move after big move with each other. As right now you can see Tyler Parks trying to put the nail into the coffin with that gold rush, but it was not meant to be. You have to give it up for Tyler Parks. He tried everything he could to put TJ Kennedy away, but the young lion with too much heart was able to hit 7 degrees of trauma and get the victory and retain his celestial championship.
He earned it. He absolutely earned it.
I can tell you, Shazine's probably not going to like this.
The first match for the Blacklist. Not a successful one, but a successful one for the young lion, TJ Kennedy.
Zach is right, though. I mean, there's...
Yeah, I'm going to be honest. I really hope Zach Stone walks away with the DCA World title tonight after everything that guy's been through this season.
I mean, I think that can be said for most people here in the crowd, but remember, it's like he said, the Blacklist always have a trick up their sleeve. You know, it's not just going to be him and Casey Gordon out there. He knows this. Amber knows this. He knows that he's going to be facing the entire Blacklist. The Blacklist are going to do everything in their power to keep that title around Casey Gordon's waist.
The question is, has Zach Stone, he's always been a loner. He's had that us against the world mentality for quite some time. Is anyone other than Amber Stevens going to have the back of the challenger tonight? And you know, there's, you know, remember during the first season, Zach Stone walked out in his company, and I find it, I don't know, I know time heals all wounds and all that, but you know, can you really be sure that he's been forgiven for that? Has he been forgiven by the locker room? I mean, has he made amends? Let's hope he has. Because if he hasn't, it's gonna be uphill sledding for Stone to become the World Heavyweight Champion tonight.
Well, I haven't been here long, but if there is one thing I've learned from my short time here, is that while some people might not like Zack Stone, they definitely do not like the Blacklist.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're just moments away from a grudge match that's centered around the DCA World Championship. It is the Soldier, Atlas Jones, taking on the Young Gun, Smokey.
This one is sure to be one hell of a fight between two men that just cannot absolutely stand each other.
Yeah, who could forget what happened at Gateway to Heaven?
Atlas Jones as the special referee. Cost. Yeah, I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was going to finish your sentence. Cost Smokey his match for that DCA World Championship against Casey Gordon, which has only made the flames burn a lot brighter in this rivalry between him and Atlas Jones. Now you can see Atlas Jones making his way down to the ring, getting ready for possibly the fight of his life. And believe you me, I can tell that this man has seen a lot of fights in his career, but I think this one might top each and every one of that.
The first ever DCA World Champion, the only man to win it more than once.
Man is a front runner here in DCA.
Is it day one or two? How do I? He has been on the front lines of DCA, both literally and figuratively.
Thank you.
is a legend in the world of virtual wrestling.
Man, look at what Smokey's wearing.
Dare I say it, looks like Smokey's dressed for war here tonight.
Kind of a big FU to Atlas.
Probably.
This man, Smokey, like you said, Eddie, a legend in virtual wrestling, been here, been in this business for around 10 years. A man who's been everywhere. Any promotion, any big virtual wrestling promotion in the world, you name it, this man has been. He's seen it all. He's done it all. He's won championships. He's gone up against some of the best that virtual wrestling has had to offer. And tonight is no different as he goes up against the two-time DCA World Champion, Atlas Jones.
This isn't going to be a match. This is going to be a fight.
Just as soon as you say that, these men are already trading hands with one another.
Looks like Smokey's getting the better. Look out. I was about to say he was about to get better in the exchange until that happened.
Now Smokey and Atlas just continue to brawl to the outside.
Hello, Oka!
Oh, the back body drop!
What the
hell? Oh my god!
Nice spine buster by Atlas.
This is not known as qualification, by the way, though there is a 20 count DCA, I'm pretty sure. No, I know for a fact. Oh god.
Yeah, these two don't care. I'll help you finish. These two do not give one damn about that 20 count. The only thing that they care about is beating the absolute hell out of each other.
Couldn't have said better myself.
Is now Smokey breaking up that count there, picking up Atlas. Atlas now sending Smokey back into the ring.
See? Finally, both men back in. Wonder how long that lasts. And clothesline sends Atlas out. And if you had not long, you are a winner.
Now, Atlas Jones sending Smokey into the guardrail. What is this? Asim.
Ouch!
Oh!
Smokey's definitely going to feel that one.
Have these two even battled in that ring yet?
No, I don't think they've even gone in the ring.
They haven't in the opening seconds.
I mean, they started. I'm not sure if they've actually...
If it's actually lasted longer, now they're in the ring.
Now fighting into the ring here.
I mean, 30 seconds tops, I think. About now. Right up to this point, maybe.
It's not,
look out!
And now they're gonna battle back on the outside, I guess.
It's now Smokey looking to go after Atlas. Atlas tries to take advantage, but gets kicked back by Smokey! Smokey trying to go for it!
Oh man.
Just a straight boot to the chest and now just sending his leg into the steel steps.
Well, now it's up to about 40 seconds of total time in the ring.
Atlas.
Now back into the ring they go. And,
This is not no DQ, right?
This is not a no disqualification match.
Now, Atlas now trying to get back. Oh, now going up to the top here. Double. No, wait.
Oh!
Nice backbreaker there by Smokey.
That veteran-like instinct there by Smokey. And now outside the ring they go again.
I think it's now up to maybe 60 seconds.
And just a straight punch to the head by Smokey there.
Yeah, it's been
about
a minute in the ring and about three on the outside. I will give them credit. They are utilizing the most of that 20 count.
You have to know that even though the ring in there, it's not a trampoline, ladies and gentlemen, but you know that the outside doesn't feel any better. Make no mistake about it, these two are using the environment to
Was that on the steel steps?
Yes it was!
I believe it was!
Yes it was! Yes it was!
He just spine busted him into the steel steps in a backbreaker!
They didn't get counted out, they don't get back in the ring!
Atlas has to be very wary of that 20 count.
I think both men don't care about the 20 count.
Second. Oh, and just slamming him back
15
down.
Now 16.
And now Smokey breaking up the count again.
A
back body drop by Smokey, and I'm not sure if that might have been way too close.
That was way close.
And now back into the ring they go. It's now Smokey going up top. No. Wait a second.
Oh boy, this doesn't look good for Smokey. Atlas Jones looks like he's gonna go for a superplex.
The most overused move in professional wrestling.
I was waiting for that. As now, Smokey now has him. Oh, and a nice wrist lock clothesline there.
Now Smokey perhaps looking good.
Wait a second. Dragon suplex. Two.
Almost got the pinfall there. Nice big boot to the face there by Smokey.
And when you've been battling outside the ring as long as these two, I mean, the damage has to be done already. Backbutt stunner!
That might be it. Oh,
no!
Batman positioning there.
Not paying attention to where he was in the ring, and it cost him. As now Smokey has him again. Wrist lock, clothesline once again. Atlas now going in control. Oh my god!
Brock Lesnar would love that suplex right there.
A German suplex that just completely folded Smokey in half.
Oh, what's Atlas got planned now?
Oh, wait, oh!
Whatever it was countered by Smokey.
Smokey now, looking for something here. Wait a second, no, Atlas Jones with the back elbow. Oh my god!
The front line scores!
But again, not paying any attention to where he was, he gets caught with the slide buster. And now, splash!
Yeah, Smokey missed it with that frog splash. What's this?
Oh! My god!
Almost like the snowplow.
But only good for two.
I've never seen him use that.
And now it's Smokey with a big boot to the chest.
A very back and forth match between these two.
Now look at this. Oh! A little bit of rolling thunder there. Now, what is this?
Could be. Oh!
Razor! Razor's Edge powerbomb by Smokey, two, and he's got it!
Only good for two there. It's now Smokey looking for something. No! Atlas Jones turns it around on him. It's now Atlas, now just looking to finish this match off once and for all. But Smokey not letting it happen.
Nice counter there by Smokey into the hip toss. And now Smokey looks like he's going on top.
Good splash, no! And now Alice again setting him up.
Oh, Alice! Oh, Alice dead! No!
Smokey! Acid splash!
He got it!
He got him with the acid splash. One, two, ooh. Almost got the three count after that, but almost only counts as horseshoes and hand grenades.
How in the hell did Atlas Jones kick out of the acid splash into the pin? Two? No!
Definitely a hell of a match so far.
Oh my god, now he's just beating his chest in! Smokey is down. Now, Atlas Jones, what's he coming up here? Oh my god!
Into the post.
Damn.
What is Atlas thinking up here?
I don't like the look on his face.
What the world is he thinking of?
I think he may be looking for the front line.
Atlas!
Oh! Wait!
I did not have a Subway sub on me.
These two are trying to kill each other, and I'm not even sure if any of Iron Man's
referees counting. Smokey able to recover just enough to hit the Spinebuster on the Atlas through this table, and it took everything he had. Both men are down.
And it's over. Both men have been counted out.
What a match.
We have no winner.
War between those two.
Even after all of that, these two are still not able to settle it because we still don't have a winner.
This isn't good. One more look at the...
Just look at this, right here. Spine Buster. Once again, another look at the Spine Buster through the announce table. Smokey was able to muster up just a bit more strength for that Spine Buster, but in the end, he just collapsed. And neither man was able to make it into the ring by the count of 20.
And how appropriate it ended out here since they spent most of this match out here.
I mean, that is an excellent point. Both men... Oh my god, they They might have legitimately tried to end each other's career here tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
They both went to war and none of them came back.
How the hell did this table get fixed so quickly?
You guys have the Flash on your payroll?
I don't know if we have the Flash, but we have the best damn crew in the business putting this table back together. I mean, it may be held together with, you know, duct tape and chicken wire, but... But ladies and gentlemen, can we get some help, please? We're going to have to get some help for Rattler Jones and Smokey. I mean, we need a table, but we do need a table, but they need help. If we can...
They're not... Oh boy, those two, they hurt each other.
Yeah,
you're getting them both out of here.
Mike, I tell you what, they will be feeling the effects of this night for a long time, and Zahaya, I think you mentioned it, nothing was settled. After all that they went through, nothing was settled.
You know that at the end of the day, even when they didn't get any sell, that just means this thing, I am pretty sure this thing's going to continue. These two are not going to stop going at it until they find out who is the better man once and for all.
Yeah, they'll both kill each other trying to figure that out.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have to move on here. In just a few moments, we will have a first. As in a first time ever. The Killer Monarch, Dani Gibbons, will go 1-on-1 with the Scorpion, Cleopatra Sphinx.
Two of the finest women here in virtual wrestling going at it to make a masterpiece in that ring. For the first time ever, it's Cleopatra Sphinx taking on Dani Gibbons.
I'm personally excited for this because I get to call my first Cleopatra Sphinx match.
Well, you are definitely in for a treat.
And I'm going to assume this will also be the first match involving Dani Gibbons that you call, right, Vipok?
No, I did call the her title match at the Kiryuka War at Gateway to Heaven.
Oh, that's right. That's correct.
Oh, here she comes. Cleopatra Sphinx.
The wife of the true chess master, Chris Knight.
Which is basically how this entire rivalry got started, with Malik and Dani pretty much going after both Cleopatra Sphinx and Chris Knight. And you know that with this match, there's also the other match with Malik Brown and Chris Knight when they meet off in that street fight later on tonight.
Right. That, by the way, as I mentioned at the top of this thing, they will start in the parking lot. Malik Brown and Chris Knight, they will start in the parking lot and they will have to fight their way into the ring. And only when they get to the ring can the match be won.
Right now you can see Cleopatra Sphinx getting ready to take on Dani Gibbons. First time ever. Like I said, two of the best women's wrestlers in the virtual wrestling circuit today. We're gonna find out who is the better woman in the middle of that ring. Because right now, here comes the personal favorite of mine, Dani Gibbons.
Perhaps the most accomplished woman in the history of Terror Dome Championship Wrestling Asterisk. Four-time women's champion. And probably, some would say definitely, pound for pound, the best women's virtual wrestler in the world. And that's hard to disagree.
You definitely can make claims that she is one of the best, if not the best, in virtual wrestling today. But make no mistake about it, she's going up against another woman who is looking to make that claim as well in Cleopatra Sphinx.
It is a pioneer of women's virtual wrestling. And a match as recently as 2 months ago, no one thought would ever happen, is about to happen right now.
As here we go, Dani Gibbons, Cleopatra Sphinx, tying up in the middle of the ring now. And now just a stalemate here, but now Gibbons gaining advantage here. Wait a second, now Cleopatra Sphinx with the waist lock. Now Dani Gibbons with the headlock, wrist lock here, waist lock. And now on to another wrist lock here and just pushes her off. And another stalemate there. It's going to be very interesting to see who can gain the clear advantage in the early goings in this match.
Right now, I was about to say Gibbons looks like she was in complete control here until that happened.
Cleopatra Sphinx rolling out of it there.
Leapfrog, two leapfrogs.
Oh! Landing her right on top of her head.
That was out of the Cleopatra playbook there. That running DDT. Danny blocking the drop. Danny gets the drop kick blocked.
Cleopatra Sphinx now with a slam.
Nice scoop and a slam there. You know she's got to be reeling. She just got spiked into the mat. And oh my god, a spinning side slam from Cleopatra Sphinx. Pulling it on a one count there. I'll tell you, that only shows me the type of toughness that these two women have in each other.
Nice knee lift there by Dani Gibbons. But I don't think she even got a one on that.
She did not.
Dani Gibbons now. Wait a second. Cleopatra Sphinx. Out. Wait, no. Dani now. Forearm to the head. Dani now. What's she thinking of here? Sends her off the ropes. Ducks down. Oh, wait a second. Tries to go for a lariat takedown. Man does not get it. It gets caught. Will.
Oh! German suplex!
Very impressive there.
We haven't even gone 5 minutes into this match that these women are already hitting each other with everything they've got.
Carver hits and standing down, but only gets a near fall.
Gibbons looks like she's in a lot of trouble now as Cleopatra puts her in the tree of woe.
Oh, but quick to get out of that tree of woe position, and there you see the lariat takedown in effect. Now what is this? Oh, wait a second. Oh, into the Hurricane Rana. Dan, wait a second. No, Cleopatra. And a kick out from Dani Gibbons.
Both women kicking out quickly. Both women bringing out the heavy artillery here in this match in the early going. Nice.
Ooh, I can feel it. Felt that one.
Yes. Is now Cleopatra Sphinx. Oh, wait a second. Tries to go for a kick. No, Dani Gibbons blocking it. What is Dani thinking of here? Now sends her off. Now Dani Gibbons. Now look at this. Nice athleticism there from Dani Gibbons to hit her with that crossbody.
Very impressive there by Dani Gibbons.
By the way, you're seeing a link on your screen right now. This is a very important link you see, okay? Both of these ladies are nominated for Wildcat for DCA Wildcat of Season 2. There's the DCA Awards. Voting is going to begin on that as soon as this event concludes. Tomorrow night, if you're watching on the stream. So, let's see. Starting Saturday night, the vote will open as soon as this thingamajig is open. Or if you're watching this on YouTube right now, you can vote right now. But I'm sure there's a time limit. All the is
there by Dani.
Now Cleopatra Sphinx getting out of that waist lock there. Now going for more kicks.
And voting will be open until January 1st of next year.
Ah, so there is a time.
Nice Shiranui there from Dani Gibbons.
Some people may call that sliced bread. Sliced bread number one, man. Oh! Goodness!
Cutter with that leg, wear it from the top rope, two and no!
Cleopatra fixed now set to the corner, but she explodes right out of it.
Oh, spinning net breaker.
Now where's Cleopatra going?
Cleopatra looking for something here. But it's like, oh, God!
Yikes.
Oh, whatever it was, it backfired because Dani just knocked her to the outside.
A suicide dive from Dani Gibbons.
She landed right on her feet, too.
That just shows you the type of athlete, that type of wrestler that Dani Gibbons is. He's now looking to stay on the attack here. Has her up in the air. Oh my goodness!
Nice move there by Dani.
Because now Cleopatra seems to be in trouble. No way, kicks Dani off. Here comes Cleopatra with a nice clothesline takedown. And now look at this! Oh! Trying to go for a springboard crossbody there. Moved out of the way. And now a lion salt from Dani Gibbons.
Two.
It was not a three.
This isn't looking good for Cleopatra. And I take back what Dani. I just said.
Oh, Dani just caught both an elbow and a kick to the head. As now
that
Cleopatra
sucks.
Sinks on the top rope. 450!
Oh, no!
Moves out of the way and puts Hunter!
He shook it off like it was nothing.
And now we're going to take a little bit, and we're going to take you right back to this replay here with that forearm shot from Dani. Get this suicide dive, able to land right back on her feet.
She threw a little hazard pose there.
Oh, a super kick.
There's the cover. Two. No.
The attack is fixed now. Is it that leg work? Now Dani in trouble. No, Dani with an elbow to the head. Arm drag takedown. Now what is this? Oh, look at this small package here.
Two.
Covered by Cleopatra.
No, wait. One.
Dani
two.
No. Only two.
Both women have been going back and forth with those roll-ups there. As now Dani Gibbons looking to finish this one off. Has her up on the shoulders. No, elbow to the head. And now Cleopatra now. What's she thinking up here? As both arms hook. Look at the strength of Cleopatra's face with that butterfly suplex.
Very impressive there by Cleopatra. And now she's telling Dani to get up.
This could be bad news for Dani Gibbons, as now Cleopatra Sphinx turns her around. No.
Oh,
elbows. Dani coming back.
Wonder if she was thinking clear of the outlet. Oh, what a drop kick.
And answers right back with a boot to the side of the head, and now Cleopatra Sphinx! What in the world?
It's a cover.
Not sure what she's going for there, but whatever it was effective, but only got a two count.
And now, oh, wait a second, gets caught with a small package.
Two.
And now it turns it right back around. And a kick out from Dani there.
What a battle this has been between these two women.
Really, could you expect anything less from two top athletes such as Cleopatra Sphinx and Dani Gibbons? Now Cleopatra sends her into the corner here. Oh, she's trying to go for it. Answer with a boot! And now Dani. Oh,
oh
no.
Oh, this could be it.
Oh!
Damn it, Green Royale!
Into the pin! Two! No!
Just kicking out at the last second.
Dani Gibbons now looking for strikes. Oh, and just gets clocked with the strike to the back of the head. Now what is
What's this?
German
oh! turned her inside out with it.
Now wait a second. Oh, roll up here. One, two. Oh, kick out. Now what is this? Oh, wait a second. Oh my God!
Quicksand driver!
Into the pin off the quicksand driver. You and no!
What?
And now staying on the attack. Oh, what a bulldog! Springboard bulldog. And now Cleopatra! So missed the super kick! And now look at this! Cross face!
And she's got that arm hook too!
This could be it!
Sort of on a bell lock, if you will! In the middle of the ring! Cleopatra stinks of a lot of trouble! And Dani Gibbons is not letting go of that hold!
She's nowhere near the ropes either!
Cleopatra's gotta find a way to get out of this or submit here.
Oh my God, Dani just wrenching back on it right now.
And Dani's not letting go. Cleopatra, now you can see Cleopatra finally trying to move here. Cleopatra finally trying to move.
Those ropes might as well be a mile away for her.
But she is trying with every fiber of her being to...
She got the ropes right there!
Yeah, she did! She got it!
Oh my goodness!
Just got the ropes and...
Dani Gibbons trying to push her to her breaking point. Now we can see another Green Royale! Royale. No! And now another quicksand driver! No, nope. Wait! Neckbreaker! We'll take another look at this replay here. Look at this, the Demi Green Royale from Dani Gibbons here. Bam, right there. I thought this one might have been over after that one. Into the pin, one, nope. Two, but Cleopatra Sphinx with enough willpower to kick out there.
Oh, there's enough willpower to kick out. She got near fall right there. It's the quicksand driver. Oh, hang on, Lysol on the ring, two.
So yes. Much action going on here, it's hard to keep up, ladies and gentlemen, but gets caught by Dani Gibbons with that drop kick. No, kicks her away, and now Dani Gibbons, wait a second, backbreaker.
Two, three, no.
Almost three. Oh! Kicked there by Dani.
Oh, but wait, look at Cleopatra!
What?
Just kicked right back up to her feet. And now, here comes Cleopatra's feet. That is a huge elbow. And now,
sharpshooter!
The sharpshooter!
Let me correct myself, that is the Scorpion Deathlock, we all know it.
Sharpshooter, Scorpion Deathlock, whatever you want
to call it. She calls it the Scorpion Deathlock, so we will call it that.
People call it the Scorpion Deathlock, but she's got the Scorpion Deathlock on Dani Gibbons here. Now trying to reach for the ropes.
Can Dani get to the ropes, though?
Do it. He's so far away, though!
She's trying to...
pushing herself back from the rope! Danny's still trying to get to it! Yes, she does!
Oh my God!
How in the hell?
Somehow, some way...
Here we go!
Are you kidding me right now?
Look at these two
staring each other right in the face, and now just going at it, striking at each other. How badly do both of these women want to win this match?
They're giving everything they've got because these two ladies know they're... Wait, hang on! Small package!
No way! God! And now, Dani Gibbons, once again, she's setting it up! Dani!
What is doing?
Two! Three!
What's it gonna take to push to put one of these women away?
I have no idea. At this point, I have no idea what you could possibly do to put either of these women away. They will not stay down.
Dani with the line assault!
And now, Dani. A little kind of taunt here. Another Dani group. No! Cleopatra!
Counters!
And now! Double footstop now! Wait a second!
Oh, look at that!
Wait! Driver! One! Two! Jesus! Get it!
Wow!
I am absolutely speechless. These two women just put on a classic wrestling match here in the Levi Stadium. Dani Gibbons and Cleopatra Sphinx, they gave it all they had in the middle of that ring.
Hey, I have a proposition for everybody. If this match is not on the match of the year voted for the DCA Awards, it kind of needs to be now. Because, yeah, this was good. This was awesome. This was amazing.
These two, back and forth, they did everything in their power to get the victory. Dani Gibbons, Cleopatra Sphinx, making great claim on why they are the two absolute best in virtual wrestling. Gender be damned, these two put on one hell of a match.
It certainly was. They threw everything but the kitchen sink at each other. And in the end, it was Cleopatra Sphinx standing tall.
It's a shame that one of them had to lose.
It's a damn shame that Cleopatra was able to get the victory here. What a match.
Seriously?
That was absolutely incredible.
Right, so how do we follow that?
StarrStruck. Oh, wait a second!
That's the Neo Diva Revolution!
Are these two women again?
What's their problem? I mean, if I recall, StarrStruck is one of the... Turmoil match, right? If I recall.
I mean, they were supposed to be, but...
Isn't that match supposed to be next?
Right, it is the DCA Wildcats Championship. Dynasty taking on Mario and Megan, taking on Alika Adult. And supposedly StarrStruck, but StarrStruck just got taken out.
Can someone tell? You have got to be kidding me!
That's Neo Diva Revolution's music, if I'm not mistaken.
You're correct! What the hell are you doing out here? You're not in this match!
Can we get... What is going on?
I think they're putting themselves in this match by force. I think they're going to forcefully take StarrStruck's place.
Come on!
If there is a living, breathing commissioner in this goddamn company, someone needs to drag these two out of here.
The Neo Diva Revolution forcing their way into this match by despicable claims is absolutely disgusting.
You guys have no security.
I'm sorry, but this is bullshit. Oh my god.
Considering who they're facing, I don't think they're gonna
never let it be said. Ladies and gentlemen, let's see your face, by the way, for Lincoln Delilah.
Yeah, since I'm the new guy here, care to fill me in on these two?
Well, I'm... as are the Neo Diva Revolution. Alika and Delhia won the women's tag team, the Wildcats tag team titles earlier this season. They were stripped of those titles by Shazam Freya. They were forced to hand them over to the Neo Diva Revolution. Both of these teams were once upon a time in the blacklist together. Neo Diva Revolution still led it. Alika and Delhia did not. Even though they were still recognized as the champions at the time. Goodness.
You can see right now, Alika just going on the attack. It's not, look at this. Oh, a nice hurricane on a takedown.
And at Wildcats DXD, the two teams faced off and the Neo Diva Revolution, they screwed Alika and Delhia out of the tag team, out of the Wildcats tag team titles. But Alika and Delhia still say they never lost the belt, which, if you think about it, oh goodness! Lexi with the running boot onto Alika there gets just the one count. Since they were never legitimately beaten for the titles, they're still champions as far as they're concerned. By the way, for those of you new to Destiny Championship Alliance, first of all, welcome. For the Neo Diva Revolution, that's Lexi Blue, that's the one in the pigtails, and on the other side there, Matt Patriot. Oh! That is Bailey LaRoe, and this is Delhia. And for the first time for Alika and Delhia.
Delhia looking to do some damage here.
Oh!
So I believe you said her name is
Lexi. What an uppercut by Delhia.
Oh! Dropkick!
Dropkick takes out two, but that may have been a costly mistake there. And now Lexi, oh!
Lexi with that... with that face buster there, and now up on her shoulders. Wait a second, no, inverted DDT by Delhia!
Cover, near fall.
Now Lexi, staying on the attack on Delhia here.
Delhia.
Okay, yeah.
I always thought it was Delhia. But I'll be honest with you. I never thought to ask. I mean, I'm not going to ask.
Look, look. That was a nice double team move by the Neo Diva Revolution.
The hardcore messiah is Delhia. Calls herself. I mean, come on. I'm not going to. No. No.
When you call yourself the hardcore messiah, you kind of.
No.
You kind of want to keep away from someone with a nickname like that.
Right.
It's only natural.
Right.
You know?
You understand.
It's now right to the eye, though. And now into the corner goes Delhia.
Delhia's in a lot of trouble right now.
Another tag out here. Oh, and just sending her back first into the turnbuckle.
We're just gonna allow this.
Look, the match has already started. We got the two teams in the ring. There's not really much we can do right now.
Nice flapjack there by Lexi.
I mean, Lucinda probably, you know, if Lucinda didn't have a match prepared for, she would fix this shit, right?
Hey, I bet she would. And more double team action here for the Neo Diva Revolution.
I mean, StarrStruck should get something for this. I mean, they should be first in line for the tag titles for next. I mean, this shit can't slide. First show of the new season. First takedown, first Wildcats, first whatever.
Well, provided that Lucinda wins her match later on tonight, maybe, but until then, I wouldn't hold my breath on it.
They were able to kick away. And...
Oh my god! Delhia catching her in midair and power slamming her.
And here comes Alika now with that double axe handle and then just shoulder blocking Lexi off of the apron there.
They could go behind. Oh! It's a roundhouse.
Gets caught with the kick, and now here comes once.
Down goes Alika, down goes Delhia. Yeah,
Lexi, bombing blow to the face.
Yeah, she might want to...
Lexi now taking a little bit of time.
Time 20 is time not following up. See? By the way, this is a turmoil match, so there are still two teams to go here. Ken Kaiserman, the champions, and Mari Penn and Megan Van Horn. And if I were to bet any reasonable amount of money, I know who's going next. I don't know, but I have a gut feeling.
Yeah, so do I, Eddie. So do I.
And now, oh my god! Belly suplex nearly tossed halfway across the ring.
I see what you did there! Oh, and Delhia setting Lexi down and lets her know what she thinks of her or something. Bale with a running bulldog, but Alika right back up.
Now Bale with the... Ooh. Oh, trying to go for a kick there, but... Oh, gets caught by a German suplex!
Taking right to Suplex City.
And now, here comes Delhia. The Hardcore Messiah into the match.
Down goes Bailey. Down goes Lexi. Neck breaker by Delhia.
That went a huge boot there. Now, what is this? As they're set up here. Oh, curse stop!
Cover! Oh!
Wait a minute. I might want to have to check the replay on that pin, because I could have sworn that was a three count.
Okay, his tag is made. Lexi's in. What's this?
Oh, my God!
The ugly tag!
And down goes Alika.
The ugly tree. Oh my gosh, that is StarrStruck music.
Oh my god.
I think they have come to take their spot back.
In the words of the famous ring announcer, Vince is picked up.
Where are they?
Right.
And now look at this. Delhia, Alika. Oh my god.
There's
the cover. And the Neo Demon Revolution's been eliminated.
StarrStruck's music distracting.
Lexi Blue and sweet, sweet justice.
Revenge here just a little bit StarrStruck as they were able to get the Neo Diva Revolution out of this match.
Well, remember there's still two more teams left in this matchup.
This is a good point. You're absolutely right.
So Alika and Delhia have no time to celebrate here.
Yeah,
they gotta get ready to pick against the other team. But now look at this backbreaker.
Oh!
And elbow drop combination there.
Shades of demolition there. I mean, the match didn't last too. They may still be a bit fresh, but they won't be as fresh as whoever's coming down that ramp.
And now, oh! Wait a minute!
It's the Kenny Cosmo!
Oh, God!
Wow! I'll be honest with you, I did not expect these two to be next!
Neither did I, Eddie. Neither did I.
Well, you can see why they were able to get the drop on both Alika and Delhia here. And now, wait a second.
No!
Delhia now turns around the kid, and I was just... Oh!
Ow.
What a move there by Delhia. On the kid.
And now look at this.
It cover two, no.
Alika going to work on Kaiser in here. And now look at this. What the hell? Oh my god.
Ooh. Split legged.
Leg drop.
What? Oh, Kaiser sent to the other.
What?
And just like that, the champs have been eliminated.
The champs are out.
Are you kidding me?
We're gonna have new Wildcats tag champs!
Guaranteed new Wildcats tag team champions! Chris was able to catch off guard with the face buster!
And this, and mind you, this was after the kid and Kaiser jumped! Alika and Delhia!
And then right here, kick to the midsection! And then, this split leg drop there, straight to the neck of the kid, and just like that, it's over!
The kid and Kaiser are no longer Wildcats Tag Team Champions, but the winners of this forthcoming contest will be!
So now it's just down to two teams!
And it is the team of Mari Prime and Megan.
my favorite pirate duo of DCA. Granted that they may be the only pirate duo, but nonetheless.
Wait, wait.
And they're coming out the music from Soul Calibur.
Hold up.
Awesome.
Hold up. Megan is Megan wearing a... Has Megan embraced the pirate life?
I'm digging this team right now.
Eventually, Eddie Mac, you knew it was just a matter of time. And now we are going to see if we are going to have the first ever DCA Wildcats Pirate Tag Team Champion.
Hey, you might want to batten down the hatches for this one.
This could be a history-making moment in DCA. We might have the first ever pirate champions here if Mari Pond and Megan Van Horn are able to beat the team of Alika and Delhia.
Oh, and Alika getting snared there by Mari. And oh, that's a shot by Megan.
Now Megan, now snapmare. And a spinal tap there.
Even though Alika and Delhia, they didn't, you know, they... Oh, goodness. Even though they had a... Had the benefit of a quick second... Oh, look out, Delhia!
That's what I'm talking about! And now, Megan! With the pin! Cross drop!
On the last two! Three! Oh!
Jeremy Timbers!
I know it's not very commentary-like to pick them, but I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, I know the feeling. I know the feeling.
I'm gonna try to keep it professional as I can, but we could be seeing history in the making.
I mean, both of these teams are famous, but this crowd, I believe, is heavily favoring Van Horn and Pan.
Is now, what is this? And now...
Here we go.
Double DDT from Megan and Mari. Is now Mari now tagging back out to Megan. Nice teamwork here from the unlikely duo of Megan Van Horn and Mari Pan.
Unlikely as they are, they have formed a, dare I say, a somewhat cohesive unit.
Just based off their chemistry as a team in their Pirates Life episodes.
Did you see when they went to get training at the Pirates of the Caribbean right at the Magic Kingdom? Did you see that?
No, I didn't. I want to go back and watch that.
But it's Alika and now Delhia back in. Now mind you, Alika and Delhia, even though they had the benefit of a quick second match.
They are no longer the freshest team in this match. That belongs to Mari Pond and Megan Van Horn, even though you said again their two matches were quick. Megan Van Horn and Mari Pond have yet to wrestle a match, so that automatically makes them the freshest team in this one.
Take down by Delhia. And Alika Delhia for the bulk of the season, I wouldn't say the bulk of the season, but definitely for the second half of the season. Since they were screwed out of the Wildcats Ag Titles, they've been wanting them back, and now they stand right on the doorstep of getting those titles back, but...
Well, they have to go up against the two favorites here in this match, Mari Pond and Megan Van Horn. Are we going to be living a Pirate's life here in DCA?
I'll be honest, I kind of hope so.
And a tag out to Alika here. And now Maripana in big trouble. Double backbreaker.
Here's the cover.
One, two, no, Megan breaking up the pin. Knee to the back from Mari. And now Mari looking to do damage here. Drop kick to the head. Oh, and now look at this, a hit toss. I mean, we already saw one team reach their dreams by becoming DCA Tag Team Champions in the team of BillyLee. Could we be seeing the same with Maripan and Megan Van Horn? Nice chop there from Mari. And I'm not sure if she's drunk or whatever's happening, but she's falling down a lot in this match.
She's probably drunk.
Crucifix sit out powerbomb from Alika 2!
Just kicking out the last second.
Just tossing it right back into the corner of that clothesline.
The Alika and Delhia may not be as fresh. They definitely do have the experience as a team. And it is showing here.
But they're not pirates.
That is true. They are not pirates.
But they're not pirates, but they are two of the toughest in the game.
Same can be said for Mari and Megan as well, Mari has been taking a lot of damage, but she is staying in this one.
Mari and Megan, they gotta win this for pirate fans everywhere.
Now look at this. Oh, no.
Stop!
Oh boy. Come on now.
You don't have to do that.
Thank God.
I mean, I can understand trying to go.
Flash my mind!
Well, Delhia never called herself a saint.
That's true. So.
I mean, they do want the tag titles back. I mean, how they get there is...
They had to give up those titles involuntarily. They want those titles back.
Then they got screwed out of them.
Like crook. And now look at this. And here comes Megan.
Right here says Delhia down.
Pirate in training. Making a comeback. Coming in.
Hurricane
on fire!
And another one! Megan Van Horn's a house of fire here!
Total into an arm drag!
And now Megan getting all hyped up! But Delhia there is able to stop her flurry of offense.
The second generation Van Horn may be in trouble here.
Megan now just blocked.
I bet they never thought she'd be a pirate.
Oh wait! This could be it!
Johnny! Two! Three! No!
Damn it! And now Delhia. The pin cover. Mari is able to break it up. Now off the ropes goes Megan. And now into the corner she goes. Tag out to her partner. Oh no. But ended their first match with a backbreaker elbow combination. And this could be... Wait!
Megan, stop!
Wait a second. Takes him back into the corner. And that's just going to do it again. Oh no. And there it is.
Oh! Back in time.
And you're
gonna win this.
Two.
And it's
three. Got him. Alika and Delhia have won back the Wildcats tag team titles.
It took two of them, but it got the job done nonetheless.
I mean, I gotta give it up for Alika and Delhia. They went through every single tag team in this tag team turmoil. Mind you, they didn't have to go through StarrStruck because of...
Look at this, though!
The Nia, yeah.
She got from the first... Megan got from the first Donald, one, but
first one, Megan Van Horn showing fight, showing that heart, showing that pirate lifestyle, that never give up attitude. But in the end, it was just too much. Alika and Delhia with too much fortitude and too much within themselves to get the titles back, and that's what they did.
It's been a long time coming for Alika and Delhia, but they can finally call themselves champions again.
What a win for Alika and Delhia.
Now, play in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, play. Envy's words, I mean, she, is she here? It was frightening, you know?
Very, very disturbing.
Envy made it perfectly clear that tonight she's not playing any games. This isn't the commissioner of Wildcats that we're seeing. This is Envy at her absolute worst come her match with Lucinda.
And not to mention what Akira plans to do to Vanessa Price, but we'll get to that a little later. But ladies and gentlemen, we are moments away from a return bout from Gateway to Heaven. It will be the wrestling professional, the Great D, taking on the one true star, Zach Starr.
In their last match, Zach Starr was able to get the victory. Can the Great D find a way to make up for that loss at Gateway to Heaven.
This was originally supposed to be a triple threat match, with the third participant being Dante Styles, but following Dante's match against Zack Stone at Hell in a Cell Redemption, Dante still has not been cleared for competition. So this will be one-on-one.
I mean, even for a man who's as vile as Dante Styles, you have to at least feel for him a little bit, not being able to compete in front of this humongous crowd in front of 70,000 plus people.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to feel for him, especially after what he's done to people like Zack Stone and of course what he did to Hakeem.
He is the personification of greatness. And like Zack Starr, his opponent tonight is well versed in high pressure matches and big situations in front of big crowds.
The great D making his way down to the ring. At the last CPV, these two put on one hell of a match where Zack Starr was able to get the upset on the great D. The great D has definitely not forgotten about that and is looking to rectify the past with a win over Zack Starr tonight.
Definitely going to be a hell of a match between these two.
I don't know if the great D took Zack Starr lightly the first time around, but if he did, I'm pretty sure he will not do it this time around.
Yeah, great D definitely looks like he's all business here tonight.
I mean, that's just the type of man the great D is. Even if he makes a mistake, he will look within himself to make sure with every fiber in his being that he does not make that mistake twice. Now the great D and Zack Starr looking to lock it up once again in the middle of this ring here in the Levi Stadium. Now a nice snap suplex from the great D. And now has Zack Starr again in another snap suplex. Tries to go for the back. No. That Starr now. Northern Light suplex this time into the bridge cover. Doesn't even get a one count.
Yeah, it's going to take a hell of a lot more than that to put the Great D away.
Oh! Kick right in the head.
Now Zach Starr. Go ahead.
Two of the most successful athletes in virtual wrestling. Going that. Oh! That first time around, it was every bit the dream match we thought it would be.
And now we get to see that dream match happen once again. But this time in a more higher pressure situation than ever before is now a nice head scissors takedown from Zach Starr there.
And a running knee by the Great D. And you know, Zach, he is bragged to anyone that will listen. Yeah, he beat the Great D. Yeah, he beat one of the absolute best in virtual wrestling. He beat what some may consider the face of the CAW Champions League. But
wait a second. What is Zach Starr thinking of here? Oh, look at this. Look at the strength of Zach Starr with that giant swing.
Unleashing his inner Cesaro.
And Great D, he's no small man. He's 6'7", 260 pounds.
Now the Great D looks to go on the attack here on the legs of Zach Starr. As you could tell when he first did a nice super kick to the knee, and now just focusing on the knee of Zach Starr here. And now again with another chop block. Great D knows how fast Zach Starr is. He knows that how much Zach Starr likes to go up onto the top rope. So he's making sure that becomes a non-factor in this match. Because now, what is this? Has him set up here, and a nice drop kick by Zach Starr. Straight into the head. Here's the cover, hooks the leg, but only gets a two. Now, Zach Starr here. So look at this. We can call this one a sharpshooter.
Yeah, that's fine.
As now,
Great, but Great D, he's able to wiggle out. I mean, again, the man is 6'7". You know. Oh, look at this.
Oh, now look at this. Texas Cloverleaf. Texas Cloverleaf on Zach Starr.
He is sitting down and Zach is nowhere near a rope here. He's gonna try and make his way to one. He's gonna try and crawl.
He's putting all that pressure on his knees and on the back of Zach Starr here, but Zach Starr is trying to find the strength to get to the bottom rope, and he does. As now, the Great D. Now look at this. Oh my God!
Nice counter there by Zach Starr into the DDT.
The dragon screw leg whip there.
Now look at this, rolling leg lock. And now Zach using the same strategy on the Great D that the Great D is using on him.
Great minds think alike, as they like to say. As now Zach Starr is not letting go of that knee, not letting go of that hold, and the Great D is in a lot of pain here.
He's very close to the ropes, though, but or he could just use his free leg to kick him in the face.
I mean, that's always an option.
Yeah.
Now, again, the Great D continues his assault on Zach Starr's legs here. And now what is this? Oh, and a nice face buster there from the Great D.
Can you imagine what a second victory for Zach Starr over the Great D would do for his, I will say, media future in DCA?
Not only that, what would a second loss to Zach Starr do for the Great D?
Good point.
Now the Great D looking to set up Zach Starr here. No, Zach Starr.
Now look at the face.
Now look at this, has him, and now just draws down on the knee.
Ooh.
I'm going to tell you, by the end of this match, both of these men are going to have a hard time walking out of this arena.
Not good. That is a good point.
Now another sharpshooter by Zach Starr. Great D, too close to the ropes there.
Again, the man 6'7", may, make a little effort to get him away from the ropes a little bit.
Oh, nice kick to the spine there by Zach Starr.
Now Zach Starr looks for something here. No, knee to the midsection from the great D. No, wait, Zach Starr with an elbow to the head. Now Zach Starr now, off the ropes. And a nice calf kick from Zach Starr.
Catching great D right in the face with it.
I mean, when you talk about these two men, you talk about big names and different promotions. Zach Starr, I think, the well-known, most well-known in his time in WEDF. The great D, more known in his time in CCL.
As well as XGWL.
As now the great D chopping away at Zach Starr. Zach Starr now chopping away at the great D. Now just going at it. And now the great D in a lot of trouble here. Oh, try to go for a drop kick. That drop kick looked kind of low. Thank goodness that the great D moved out of the way when he could. What was this? Oh!
Oh! DDT!
Nice DDT there from the great D. Zach Starr looks to be out here. Oh, wait a second. No, kicks him off. So Zach Starr. Now Zach Starr with the roll up here. Again, too close to the ropes.
I'm begging for Zach Starr to, like, get in his mind that the great D is 6'7". He's going to be able to reach the ropes a lot easier than, say, you.
Exactly.
I'm begging for him to be aware of that.
Nice face buster there from the great D. Great D now. Oh, wait a second. What is this? Oh, my God. Oh, dear. How in the world?
The great DDT.
He got a whole bunch of height on that great DDT there, but Zach Starr was able to kick out.
How did Zach Starr kick out of that?
Look at this again.
Oh my God, the height. He was able to do that. A man the size of Great D should not be able to perform a DDT like that.
Well, that goes to show you just how much skill and agility he has.
Now the Great D looks to continue his assault, but Zach Starr is not making it easy for him. Wait a second, elbow to the head, and the great D going up top. Spear!
Oh!
Top,
bro.
That could do it.
Hooks the leg, and it's only a two.
I gotta get credit where credit's due to Zach Starr for kicking out of something like that.
Oh, he gets caught with the crossbody! Now what is he? Is he gonna go for it? No, he's going. What?
Oh! What?
Holy!
Look at
this! Wow! That was impressive. That was impressive.
Surprised that did not go for a cover there.
Oh,
yes. There's no way! Oh my!
Got to be kidding me!
Zach Starr just did a choke slam.
Super kick! No!
Oh! Oh, wait! Greatest move of all time!
Greatest of all time! Connect! One! Two!
Three.
No! This is starting to remind me of the rest. Wait a second!
Starbreaker!
Starbreaker from Zach Starr! And no!
Oh man, I think that would have been disastrous for the great D if he didn't kick out of that.
This is starting to remind me of the Gateway to Heaven match where both men are just pulling out all the stops, but neither of the men can put away their opponent.
Nice somersault senton there by the great D.
Now the great D now has him. Power bomb position, no arm drag from Zach Starr. And now Zach Starr Oh my god!
No!
Oh, he puts Great D, got the knees up at the last second.
And the Great D!
Great elbow! The Great elbow!
The Great elbow, two! And three! Did he get it?
Three!
I think that was 2¾.
No, that...
What?
That was 2¾.
Starbreaker!
Another... Oh, God. Another Starbreaker.
I think the Great D thought that was 3-2.
And now Zach Starr has him in his sights!
Dude,
Starbreaker. No!
Again with the Ds.
The Great D! And now the Great DDT! And now the Great Elbow Drop!
He got it!
A cover.
And he did it!
He's got him! Oh my goodness!
Zach Starr kicked out a little bit too late, and the Great D was able to get the victory.
What a match this was between these two.
Indeed.
Here you can see Zach Starr. I thought he had it with that shooting star press, but the Great D was able to get his knees up at the last minute, and then you see the Great DDT. But he wasn't done there. He knew he had one more move left in him to put Zach Starr away, and he hit the Great Elbow for the 3 count.
Still, what a impressive victory for the Great D, but give Zach Starr all the credit in the world. He took the fight to him here tonight.
I mean, absolutely. Zach Starr gave everything he had, but the Great D, learning from his mistakes from Gateway to Heaven, was able to get the one-up on Zach Starr tonight.
What is Lightning thinking in challenging Akira Yokimura?
I mean, I know she calls herself, what is it, the greatest of all time?
Yes.
But even you, there's a line that you just don't cross, and you figure that Akira would be that line.
And If my life is correct, then it's a chance it might not be. This is now 3 times that Lightning has wanted to challenge Akira to a match since she's come to DCA. But why? I understand you want to be the best and all that, but...
I was going to say Lightning has a death wish.
This guy here gets it.
I mean... Yeah, yeah. I'm honestly, usually I have an answer for stuff like this, but I'm stumped on why anyone would openly challenge Akira.
Well,
has Lightning watched any of Akira's matches over the past season?
I would hope so. At least her mind is on her business, which is defending the Fever Championship. And remember, due to a pre-match stipulation, should Lightning get help from the criminals of the free world, she will not only be stripped of the season championship, she will be fired.
Well, here we go, guys. The DCA Fever Championship on the line. Kana, Iizuka, Sakura, Hagiwara, Ayumi, Nagare, and Lightning going up in a fatal four-way match for the DCA Fever Championship. This one is bound to get insane.
Yeah, well, let's hope a repeat of Gateway to Heaven doesn't happen.
Well, if it does, if it does, and you know what I mean, if it does, Lightning's gone. Bye-bye.
You will not have that Fever's Championship if the criminals of the free world get involved in this fatal four-way match. As now, here comes the Miracle Butterfly.
Or job.
That too. As I was saying, here comes the Miracle Butterfly, Ayumi Nagare, who in my mind is the rightful and deserving Fever's Champion.
She's the first ever, and still should be the only one ever, Fever Champion. She won the title about a year ago in the Virgin.
Yeah, exactly. She was screwed out of the title of Gateway to Heaven. Anybody ever figure out why the lights went off?
Still looking to it. Almost 11 months to the day that, in fact, closing in on a year, as a matter of fact. Closing in on a year to the day that, Ayumi won the Fever title in the tournament final.
Became the inaugural DCA Fever Champion and would still be Fever Champion if it weren't for the person holding that title right now.
And a crooked referee. I mean, it took like four people to get this title off of you.
Well, either way, here comes Kana Iizuka.
She's the wild card in this thing.
Definitely is.
And I believe this is my first time seeing Kana.
Kana debuted at Wildcats DXD and stared down at Ayumi following her title match. And we assumed that it would be these two, Kana and Ayumi, for the title here tonight.
But as you can see through the course of the season, plan definitely changed. With Lightning getting involved and, well, the woman who is about to come out right now getting involved in this whole situation.
The SCA Women's Champion, the strongest in the world, Sakura Hagiwara.
Wait, the league is called SCA?
Yes.
I've been always calling it C.
Well, Sakura has a chance to gain that Fever's Championship right now. I think it's time. Here she is.
Yeah, y'all go ahead.
Because I ain't gonna be
objective for shit right now.
Well, to save you the trouble and the anger, I'll just do the introduction. The self-proclaimed greatest of all time, and as you can see, somewhat getting a mixed reaction here, which is surprising. Some are cheering, some are blue, which again is surprising considering the thing she has done here in DCA. The people she has stepped on, or the person she has stepped on, Ayumi, to get to this point here at Revelation.
I guess there's a lot of Final Fantasy fans in the crowd tonight. Maybe that's why they're cheering.
Not only that, she is a well-established name in the virtual wrestling world. I mean, there's that. You know, it was like, you know, why would people cheer Hulk Hogan, you know, right after he damn near tried to kill The Rock at WrestleMania, Sigma Striker explosion!
Well, I can't say Lightning had that coming for.
And Lightning!
It hasn't even started yet.
Well,
Ayumi just wanted to get her hands on Lightning, and here we go. Lightning becoming a non-factor early on in this matchup, as now it's just three women going at it.
It should be pointed out, as this is a fatal four-way, no disqualification or countout. The first person to
score.
I believe this is sudden death, correct? I've been told this is indeed sudden death. The first person to score either a pinfall or submission will be the winner and the Fever champion. And as you probably guessed, the champion does not have to be involved in the decision for the title to change hands. So if one of these three beat one of the other, that's the same as someone beating Lightning.
And from the looks of things right now, I think that's actually going to happen.
Now Sakura going to work on Kana. We know that these two have had a bit of a storied rivalry here as of late. Kana and Sakura not very fond of one another.
You have to think, speaking of Sakura, you have to think, you know, her coming from SCA as well as Lightning, you have to think those two are the odd women out. Is, you know, it might be a bit of a SCA versus DCA divide here. Ayumi and Kana both coming in from Russell Parade, but I think as Sakura mentioned earlier tonight, anybody but Lightning to come out of this with the Fever Championship made the best lady win.
I seriously thought the league was called C.
Again, the last time, it's the initials, it's not actually called C. As now Sakura, now Ayumi. This is what I'm talking about with these multi-men, women matches. You always gotta have eyes in the back of your head. You gotta make sure that there's not another pinfall going on, because a match can end just like that. You take your eyes off the prize for a second, and your chances of winning a title is gone up in smoke.
And now Sakura feeling kind of over. And kind of no small potatoes by any stretch. Kind of felt, Kind of felt Sakura was trying to get involved in Ayumi's business, and know, Sakura, you know, she was only trying to be a good smash. She was only trying to give advice. But Kana doesn't quite see it like that. And that's how we got to look. Look at this! Look at these kicks by Kana right now!
Oh! A drop kick from Ayumi. As now Ayumi now going to work on Kana here. There's now, what is this? Oh, wait a second. Drop tall hold. Now, what is this? Oh, God, up in the air, and down she goes.
Electric chair drop by Sakura.
Oh, my goodness. Kana and Ayumi, they have faced off to each other. They're covered by Sakura in the near fall. Kana and Ayumi, they have faced each off against each other in the past. They're not going to be surprised by a whole lot. Oh! Ayumi with DDT on Sakura.
Yeah, she countered Sakura's attempt at a spear right into that DDT.
And now a side rushing leg sweep from Sakura, and now what is... Oh my!
Omega driver by Hagiwara! That might be it! 1-0, Kana!
Kana quick to break up that pinfall, and I can't blame her. This could have been over. Just like that, off of that Omega driver.
Casey Jones and SCAW would probably like that move.
Now stomp to the elbow from Kana Ayumi now.
By the way, if you're tuning in this part, if you're watching on the stream, first of all, welcome. That's the subscribe button. Do hit that. If you're watching this on YouTube, why did you skip to this part? Shame on you. Watch part one, bro. At the very least, go back and watch this part from the beginning. Also, there's a subscribe button. So hit that.
Ayumi.
Here's the cover.
No.
This is a failed four-way match for the DCA Fever Championship, but before the bell rang, Ayumi hit lightning with a strike to signal explosion. Threw out of the ring, and she's not in the picture, but we're sure she's out there somewhere.
Now Sakura. Oh!
Yeah, probably
and again, another shoulder block. And now Sakura.
Probably counting how many teeth she got.
Sakura and go! And a knee!
Knee!
Next DDT there.
Ayumi Nagare, she's nominated for a few of these DCA awards. The DCA awards, the nominations have been decided, and you will get to decide the winner following this show. Or if you're watching this on YouTube, you can kind of go ahead and do that right now. Voting is open until January 1st.
Right now you can see Sakura and Ayumi going at it. Ayumi catches Sakura with the DDT there. And now snap suplex.
Dawn has been taken completely out of the picture.
Near fall.
Now Ayumi going to work on Sakura. Sakura. Oh, and a nice boot to the head.
Sakura look. Both of these women, very similar backgrounds too, now.
Going in a two count off of that amateur wrestling side slam there. It's now Sakura now. We try to go for a drop kick out of the tree of woe position, but doesn't happen. And now Ayumi now punching her back, and a missile drop kick and missed!
Sakura swatting! Ayumi, the miracle butterfly down, and only gets him two. Remember, sudden death. If one of these two pin the other or make the other submit, the championship will change hands.
Well, right now, you think now that Lightning's been gone for the entirety of this matchup, and you have to wonder, is that really the power of the knee that Ayumi gave to her? Or is Lightning now just playing possum, waiting for a time to strike one of these two women in the ring right now?
Both of these things can be true.
Yeah, I gotta agree with Eddie on that one.
Nice springboard crossbody there into the pin, only getting a two count.
Ayumi getting really close to regaining that fever title.
If not, what is this? Kick to the knee. And now, oh, Shining Wizard!
And now, Sakura's gonna have to think about that one for a minute.
And now, look at Ayumi!
Oh, go!
Onto both Sakura and Kana.
Ayumi taking out both Sakura and Kana there. And now, wait a second, there's lightning! There's lightning! Oh my god, just pulls her hair in with a backbreaker.
Well, it looks like we were right. Lightning was just waiting to pick her spot to get back into this matchup.
Now look at this. Tilt-a-whirl arm drag. Lightning now. The crafty veteran knowing what she was doing. Now taking advantage here, and another backbreaker. And now Ayumi going at it. Going after Lightning. And now look at this, tilt-a-whirl head scissors!
You can bet your ass Ayumi's trying to make Lightning pay for what happened at Gateway to Heaven.
And you know this is exactly what Ayumi wanted, just her and Lightning one-on-one in the ring. No criminals of the free world, no one to interrupt them, just those two. So Ayumi can prove that she can beat Lightning for that Fever's Championship.
Lightning won the title at Redemption, and Ayumi looking for redemption here tonight at Revelations, the final act.
As now look at this, Ayumi revving up here, and now here she comes and just dropping the leg onto the middle rope there. It's now in a chop block, down goes Lightning. Now Ayumi now a leg drop there. One.
No!
Only a two count by Ayumi.
Lightning.
You know, she did,
back elbow.
You know she did that on purpose, that leg drop.
Oh, wow.
Oh! I mean, come on.
Yes, I know. Yeah. I get it.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, wait a second!
Just so we're on the same page.
That lethal coming. Oh, come on!
No, no! Oh, I swear to God, I was gonna have to get
I
was gonna have to get from this table, man!
Backbreaker, neckbreaker combination. And now, Ayumi, butterfly suplex.
Sakura and Kana still down on the outside.
Oh, she's for it.
Butterfly looking to end it. Oh, wait a second, knee! And now, leg drop bulldog! It's in the pin, this could be it! One, two, no!
Oh!
Almost a three count there.
No! Another backbreaker!
Now, the Fever champion just laying right hands. Into Nagare. No. Oh, yeah, Sakura back in!
Sakura now, tossing Lightning out of here. Wait a second! Oh!
Leg drop bulldog from Ayumi out of nowhere.
Single strike! Two. One, two, three! Oh!
Ayumi now! No way, Sakura!
First thing into a Samoan drop!
She's not even
throwing! Jabbing! Oh my god! Another knee! Two knees!
Sakura staggered!
But wait a second, Sakura now pushes her back! And now, No, what a clothesline from the top rope. Ayumi back to her feet, like he's taken down with the shoulder block.
Ayumi refusing to stay down. She knows this might be her last opportunity at the Fever Championship. Firefly suplex.
And now Sakura looking to finish this one off. Has her up in the air. Wait a second. No, Ayumi inverted DDT. And now Sakura getting out of there. Cross body.
Oh my goodness.
And now Ayumi all fired up here.
All she gotta do is
and
just...
And now sending lightning back into the ring.
Exactly.
Ayumi now dropping the leg on lightning.
I have no idea why the referee is counting. This is a four.
Now lightning.
Wait. What?
See? Gonna try to hit like a cross body or something from
Oh
my gosh. No one has caught Ayumi with that. Dude, no! Oh my god.
Belly to belly suplex by Sakura.
Ayumi has always been able to hit that coast-to-coast crossbody until tonight.
There's a reason why Sakura likes to call herself the strongest in the world. And now drop kick to the back. And now Sakura. Now sends Ayumi into the corner and gets caught.
Oh!
I get back up!
What?
Sakura, no selling that at all!
No, listen to the Shining Wizard!
Oh my god!
Ayumi's not done though! Oh my god, look at the strikes! Now! Oh my god!
Firefly
backbreaker.
And now look at this! Kana! Sakura!
Lightning and Kana on the outside!
Lightning and Kana, my bad.
Lightning! We have two fights going on at once, but only the one in the ring is the only one that matters at the moment!
Exactly!
And
another Shining Wizard!
And now Kana going after Lightning! And now Kana, what the hell? Oh god!
Oh god! Oh my god!
Kana and Lightning are dead!
Another butterfly backbreaker! Ayumi! Double for some no! Kana and Lightning have been taken out of this match completely! Right now, it's down to Sakura and Ayumi!
A double underhook suplex from Sakura.
Oh, I believe this is it. Oh! Swinging a miss on the elbow!
Leg drop! Into the pin!
One, two, three!
What's it gonna take?
And now look at this! Dragon suplex with the bridge!
One, two, three! No! Oh my goodness!
This match is getting insane!
Oh my god, Kana! Kana!
Where the hell she come from?
How is she even moving? How is Kana even moving after what we just saw?
Oh!
Tornado kick by Kana.
And now Ayumi going after Kana. Jabbing suplex!
Are you kidding me?
And now, again, off the rope.
StarrStruck! Got it!
Cover!
Here's the cover!
But Sakura!
No!
Close. Spinning back fist, super kick, and now roll through. What the hell? Oh my god!
The ice cream sounds a fuck cutter with a tornado kick!
and she picks up Ayumi! And now, takes Ayumi out of the ring! This is smart! Kana's gonna do it! Kana's gonna do it! One! Two! And she did it!
Kana's the new favorite champion! Oh my god!
One hell of a hectic match between all four women.
Kana Iizuka is the wild card in this match. And you can see, I want to bring a little bit of attention. She saw both Ayumi and Sakura down, but it looked like that she didn't want to even pin Ayumi. She wanted to go for them. She wanted to go for Sakura.
I'm sure she wanted a lot of people wanted Ayumi and her in a one-on-one match. But in the end, it came down to Kana and Sakura, and Kana was able to get the victory.
Well, right here you can see Sakura Hagiwara was able to take her out with that ice cream somersault, takes out Ayumi, and then gets caught back for a kick. And there you can see, just a split second, she didn't know who to pin. She thought better, she didn't want to pin Ayumi, so she throws her out of the ring, and there gives her enough time to pin the woman she wanted to all this time in Sakura Hagiwara.
There is a message there, I would think.
And now you can see Ayumi handing the title to Kana.
How about that?
A show of respect from the two women there. Ayumi wasn't able to get her Fever's Championship back, but in the end, they were able to get it off the waist of Lightning.
You have to think it's only a matter of time before those two face off for the Fever Championship. But I'm sure Lightning is probably going to have something to say about it.
If she ever wakes up from that spear she took.
This is a good one.
Yeah, Lightning might be seriously hurt. We might. Not that I'd show any sympathy to the criminals of the free world here, but I don't think she's moved ever since that spear off the top, off of the ramp.
I could barely see it from where we're sitting, but EMTs have gone down to check on Lightning. So she's okay.
That's all we can hope for.
Right.
But nonetheless, Kana Iizuka, your new DCA Fever champion.
I tell you what, I have a gut feeling that Kana is going to be a dominant Fever champion.
Well, we're gonna have to wait and find out. You know, she's gonna have some very game competition coming for that DCA Fever championship, more notably Ayumi Nagare, because we know her journey for that Fever's Championship does not stop here.
Absolutely not. I'm sure Lightning will come for it. I'm sure Sakura will come for it. Who knows how many others will come for it.
Yeah, there's plenty of women on Wildcats who can come out of the woodwork to challenge for that title.